Thank you for everyone who's here tonight and those who are watching us online. It is a holiday evening night. Thank you to our map makers for our wonderful dinner tonight. It was absolutely scrumptious. You can join us in the next 2 weeks for dinner at 5:45 and then worship at 6:30. Everyone is more than welcome. But we're glad you're with us, whether you're in person or online tonight or tomorrow, because I know some will watch tomorrow. Just announcements, just a couple things. Church will be on Sunday at 10 a.m. here at St. John Lutheran, and you are welcome to join us. And if you're not able to, you can also find us online as well. We're glad you're here this evening. Thank you for joining us, and now we begin our worship for this evening.
We'll begin with our holiday evening prayer book, please. Please stand.
Jesus Christ, you are the light of the world. Stay with us now.
love in our lives.
Amen.
Amen.
We have been reading from Romans chapter 12 this season of Lent. And so we stopped last week in verse 13. So we will hear Romans 12, 14 to 17 tonight. Paul writes, "Bless those who persecute you, bless and do not curse them. In harmony with one another, do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not claim to be wiser than you are. Do not repay anyone evil for evil, but take thought for what is noble in the sight of all." Here ends the reading. Tonight we're going to hear from one of our very own, we've had several wonderful members, and now we have a third, Rita Johnson, who we are very fortunate to have her not only be a part of our congregation, but also a leader in our community. She serves on our county. She's a county commissioner and has been so since 2012. And so I asked Rita if she could share about a program in the community that she was passionate about, so we could all learn more about it and maybe if there's any way that we can get involved in it. So thank you, Rita, for being with us tonight, and come on up and share with us.
Well, first of all, thank you all for having me. Gosh, it's been a while since I've been to a Wednesday service. I think it's pretty cool.
It was great, thank you.
This is pretty wonderful, so thank you. As Masters had mentioned, being a county, one of the coolest, should I say the coolest thing about being a county commissioner, is that you are able to be on several boards, different boards that you're appointed to, and also just kind of hold on. There are many boards, and as far as the Chamber of Commerce, Main Street, Downtown Council, some of those boards are, that really focus on the progression of downtown is really nice. But two in particular, and I'm going to focus on one, is one that I'm really, really passionate about, should I say. And first is the university, our partnership with the University of Georgia, which is called Archways. I'm going to focus on that primarily. The other is also the Georgia Regional College and Career Academy. And if you don't know much about that, you've got to know more about that, because that's a terrific institution that focuses on students that, you know, not always, school is, colleges, should I say, four-year universities is not for everybody. We know that. So what it does is focuses on those individuals that have career paths in other areas, and they identify those students and help them get placement in jobs that they can exceed in. And the College of Career Academy itself is very fascinating. You haven't got a chance to take a tour, but I highly recommend it. And they have awesome career fairs. And one of the things I'll say about this before I go into Archways is, and Katie Kassinian is the CEO of the College of Career Academy. And they have part of their technical is the justice system, because they have public safety as well in there. And they actually have a staged courthouse in there where they're now starting to do what we'll be doing, peer court. And the peer court is actually done by actual kids who have gotten visual images. And they're being sentenced, or I say mock trial, by their peers. And the lesson of that basically is so that they can actually learn from that. Their peers are the ones that are actually basically sentencing them in small things, like maybe when write an apology letter, or, you know, the idea of it is to bring the community and the youth together, should I say, and also learn something from it. So that's progressing along. So, and which is actually part of Archways, which I want to focus on, which is the topic we're talking about today. So Archways is the University of Georgia. It's a partnership with the county, the city, the Board of Education that we have with University of Georgia. We started this back in 2014. We have also instrumented several organizations and community leaders, such as the Development Authority, both our public safety entities. Chief Yates is also part of this group, so is Sheriff Dix, the Chamber of Commerce, WellStar, the Georgia College Career Academy, Georgia Power, the hospital boards, collaborative boards, just to name a few. One person from each of those entities, and also part of the governance, are part of the steering committee. I'm on the steering committee here. And the reason for this, the reason why we're actually doing this, is to identify what we call areas of improvement in the Griffin County. We need areas of improvement. So we've identified six of those areas. I'll go over those. And the idea of that is so that, you know, we all want to be able to live where we play. That's just a model that we always want to live by. So we identified several key areas that we feel like needs improvement in this community. Education, well, poverty is another. Housing, crime, health and wellness, and economic development. So as I mentioned, those groups that are actually part of this, as you notice, maybe the development authority, public safety, everybody has some type of background in this as part of this, this organization, and everybody has a say. What we do is we meet once a month, the steering committee does, and these six areas that I've identified have work issue groups, okay? And the chair of the person is a part of that background. Let's say the education would be, like a teacher would be involved in that, she'd be steering that. With crime, you know, we have Sheriff Diggs and Chief Gates also is dealing with that. So we ask to have volunteers in the community who has a passionate or background in any of those groups to participate, because we think it takes the community to be involved in this. Like I said, at the end of the day, it's all about making Griffin's body a better place to live, work, and play. So like I said, we meet once a month, so does these steering committees meet once a month. What we also do is we take a retreat every year, and the retreat is not a vacation. Let me just say this, it is a working retreat. I mean, we take the big blue blood bus, and we Spalding County, and we're working on, you know, in on the bus, okay? So it's one of those things, we take it very seriously. What we do is we find a particular, let's say, area that we want to focus on, and we will go to a county that actually excels there, okay? And we will go there, and we will spend time there, and we will mimic that place with the hopes of actually bringing it back to Spalding County and learning something from it, how we can actually make this place better. And we have found that to be very, very beneficial. And we follow a process, we set short-term goals, long-term goals. We have a strategic plan that we've implemented, and we hold each other and ourselves very much accountable. And we feel like the community, you know, is also holding us accountable, because as it is, it's not taxpayer dollars, and we want to make sure what we're doing is bettering our community. So that's one of the things that we do, and like I said, I enjoy being part of this group. As far as the results, let me tell you a little bit about that, since we've been on board for 8 years. Now, one of the things we've done, and I think Pastor's part of this, is our Pastoral Ministerial Alliance. Pastors are part of that organization where we have all the pastors actually meet. And they talk about basically, you know, how to better serve the community, understanding there. We also probably heard of this, if you haven't already, is the Charity Tracker, okay? So we actually have formed what we call a network, so that Griffin's Body has a problem, should I say this, I'll go ahead and say it, where we're a giving community, and that's wonderful, we take pride in that, but we also know that a lot of things that we're giving, a lot of the organizations are doing the same thing. So the Charity Tracker actually basically is a way of actually tracking all the charities together, who does what, when they're doing it, so that we are pretty much have an idea of making one system, let me say that. So we've implemented that. I know it's kind of, that's a moving part. So the way we do this with Christmas and Thanksgiving and just in general. When Spalding County put when the Aquatic Center on Splost, that was one of the places that we actually went to as well. We went to, I want to say it was Hall County, who has a phenomenal aquatic center there. And so we wanted to learn from them as far as, you know, what kind of aquatic center, you know, we want to have here. You know, we have a fabulous swim team that really pushed to have this Splost passed. And of course, the Griffin Gators and some other folks here. That's just part of the recreational piece of this. So, you know, that's what we actually took out of that, as we're now creating this, or building, should I say, this aquatic center. And if you don't know already, it'll be at the industrial park, is where it's slated to be. The big thing that I think most of the community is going to be very excited about, is we went to Macon Bibb County, where we wanted to mimic, and our former superintendent, his name slips me down. Yes, Curtis Jones, thank you. Who was in Macon Bibb there at the time, or now I think he still is. We went there because they managed to have a community center and to be successful with this for students for after school, and also for parents that maybe needed to go back to school and take some education and get their degrees. Basically, it's a center for kids that they have something to do, you know, after school during the summer. Not necessarily ran by the school system, But, you know, it's actually there just so that it's like a place where, you know, like I said, kids can go and social, develop their social skills, educational skills, get the extra help they need, you know, in school, as well as the parents. And a lot of times we know it starts with the parents. And we understand sometimes the parents need it as well. So that's why we want to create a happy center that actually helps both. And it would not be a center that we would have to build. We have a lot of schools, just like the College of Career Academy was actually a refurbished school. Beautiful, like I said, if you haven't seen it before. We feel like we can do the same thing with this community center. And we hope once that's implemented, that it's really going to help the kids in the community as well as teachers as well, which will help drive our graduation rates up. We hope that. We're still working on that. So all in all, you know, I'm very proud of both those organizations. Like I said, there's several that actually focus on the entertainment and the downtown area, but these two particularly, I feel like it's more community driven. We can see like direct results actually come out of those organizations. I feel like that, you know, even in the next few years, as I see us developing, we're really going to take notice about, particularly the College of Career Academy, that focuses on the technical aspect of school, and also our partnership with Archways, to see our community thriving in the direction that we wanted to go. I'm going to bounce back to the College of Career Academy just real quick, just kind of share some of the pathways that they actually have. And if you know any kids that may want to do this, I mean, there is a process, but you can get in touch with me and I'll see what I can do about it. Reach out to Katie. But, you know, you have an entrepreneur aspect of it, if those that really are focused on being a business owner. There's, of course, in engineering technology, film, you know, film's a big deal now. We know that, we've seen that here. Healthcare and nursing, CNAs. Industrial technologies, public safety, peer court, like I said, aviation, and also welding. She tells a real good story about welding and how one of our students that was in the welding program, and talk about the money, let's get real about the money. I mean, there's lots of money that you can actually make in some of these careers that a lot of kids just don't get. I mean, you think everybody needs to go to college, everybody does not need that. You know, particularly, you know, if you have skills elsewhere. And so they really focus on finding those skills that a student has and moving them in that direction. So we're hoping that'll kind of close down on the gap of those students that don't actually graduate from high school, that there are other areas for them to go to get an education so they can become productive members of the society here in Griffin. So that's it. That's all I have right now. I'll take any questions from you after service, but I just kind of want to share those things with you. And if you ever find yourself wanting to participate in anything, please let me know. You can always use volunteers.
Thank you.
your people the peace that passes all understanding and the will to live your gospel of mercy and justice through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God, remember us in your love and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come.